up by moving in that direction. This is why it's so useful in knife defense, that if I'm here and I get hold of this wrist, I can use it to move him in different directions. And it becomes not a matter of pain, it's a mechanical thing that allows us to take him to the floor.
Si on arrive à choper le poignet comme ça, c'est pas tellement une. Créer de la douleur, mais une façon de me déplacer, soit vers le haut, dans la gravité, ou vers le bas, puis ça va, je vais beaucoup bouger en fait.
But pain and leap on their own will not make someone fall over.
Mais la douleur, c'est pas ça qui va simplement faire tomber quelqu'un.
Things have to be combined with a triangle, 45 degrees on three planes to make them lose balance.
Pour en plus faire tomber quelqu'un, il faut combiner ça avec le principe de triangle 45 degrés.
An example of how it doesn't work. I have side-to-side hypotenuse. I'm using a lever. It's creating pain, and I'm moving this direction here. He does not fall over.
Donc là, il a la clé avec hypotenuse au plexus du coude. Ça me fait bouger, mais ça ne fait pas bouger.
But it has two points of support in his heel, and I draw a triangle, and I take the pressure down to triangle point, and he sits on the floor.
Rajoutant les principes de triangle et tout ça, ça tout en est.
I rotate him this way, he's now landed in the horizontal plane. I rotate him this way, he's now gone in the frontal plane. I just need to then add some sort of falls over.
And you
see now how it's important to have blocks and use them in combination with the principle.
C'est important de travailler ces clés avec les principes et les structurations.
So our first drill is we're going to take hold of the hand, either from here or here. And we're going to use it and see how we can disrupt his structure and combine it with free cleanse. How we can use it and take it to triangle, front or back, that was one to the front, or 45 degrees.